Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today, we're going to dive into the subject on the shallow end when it comes to ATV clutching and spring selection. Now, first, I want to start off by just giving you an overview of how a CVT system operates, and then we're going to discuss when you may need to make changes to that system. Now, the companies that employ a CVT system, they've done a lot of research to give you the best overall performance that does everything okay, but nothing really exceptional. And they kind of have to aim in that direction because they don't know how you're going to use your machine. Now, that being said, you can take a stock system and just alter it slightly that caters more toward how you're using your machine, whether it's going to be in really technical rocky terrain, or maybe you're out at the sand dunes where you need a lot of high RPMs, or you need to stay in that high RPM range to get the most out of your machine. Now, the way a CVT operates, you've got a series of either springs and weights pushing against each other or pulling against each other on one thing and one thing only, and that's this belt. And what is going to happen in your idle condition, you're all the way on the inside of the sheaves on your primary clutch and you're all the way to the outside on your secondary clutch. Now, as the RPMs start to come up on your primary clutch, it has a set of weights in there that are going to be fighting against the spring that's holding it together. Now, as the RPM increases, that centrifugal force is going to force pressure against the spring, bringing the sheaves together, hence pushing it further out onto the sheave itself. Now, conversely, you've got the secondary, which is doing the exact opposite. The belt is all the way on the outside, and as the RPMs increase along with the load, we have to take that into account, the exact opposite happens. It starts to pull the belt in, and that effectively, in between the two, changes your gear ratio. Over that entire range, that is how you're going from a dead stop to your top speed. And on the engine side, if you look at that as being your power supply side, the load side has more to do with the secondary sheave. Now, looking at it from a stock standpoint, all of that's designed to work together for most applications over a broad range of uses that you're going to have for your machine. Now, as I said, now if you want to get more specific, then you can curtail it to more of a sand dune application or a rock crawling adventure. Depends on what you're going to use your machine for. Now, the other thing we haven't talked about is, let's say your machine's not stock. Now, have you increased the horsepower of your machine? Well, that needs to be compensated for so where you can best apply that power. If you put on larger tires, most people do, that's another reason you have to go in and modify your setup. Otherwise, it's going to put too much of a load at the wrong RPM, and that's what we don't want to happen. So we need to readjust all of these different components to where it takes into account either having more power or more load. Now, how is the end user going to figure out which combination to go with? Well, fortunately, we've got companies like EPI, which have done all the testing and the work for you. I mean, there's several others that you can get complete clutching systems built up from scratch. I mean, if you're into that level of performance. Now, let's say you've only put on larger tires than that exhaust and you're going to spend most of your time in the sand dunes. Well, they have a primary and secondary spring kit along with the necessary weights for the primary to best implement the power to the ground. Now, let's look at the other end of the spectrum and say, well, you've got larger tires, different exhausts, but you want to rock crawl your machine. Well, they've got a system for that as well. Has a little bit different weights, different primary and secondary springs, and then they even replace the helix, and that changes the secondary clutch engagement rate, if you will. Now, if you're really trying to dial your machine in, we do offer a couple of different kits from both Dynajet and Bikeman Performance. These two kits, they are fully adjustable, especially on the weighting side, where you can really dial it in depending on how you're going to be using your machine on any given weekend. All this stuff is unbelievably complicated, and I'm glad there are a lot of people out there much smarter than I am that have taken the time to figure it all out. But the good part is, we don't have to have a mechanical engineering degree to reap the benefits of all this technology. All you need to do is just get in touch with us and let us recommend the best setup for your machine, for your application. Well, listen, this is just a very basic look at what you need to do if you're going to modify your machine or use it in a particular format. Otherwise, you better stock up on a bunch of belts because you're going to burn them up because your machine is not set up in using your clutching system as it should be for your particular application and setup. Well, listen, if you need any of these parts for your own machine, why don't you come see us at Partzilla.com and we can get you taken care of. Have any questions, comments about this video? Leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, if you want to keep up with what we're talking about in the next one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button along with that notification bell. That way you can keep up with whatever I'm talking about next. Listen, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Partzilla, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.